Battlefield victories. Brutality. And the bogus promise of utopia in a self-declared caliphate. Islamic State shocked the world when it seized swathes of Iraq and Syria in 2014. But it also surged across the grey zone of the internet, winning recruits and spreading terror. In their first joint interview, the head of GCHQ and a top general reveal new details about how the UK used cyberspace to fight back against the group also known as Daesh.
We piloted some really early technologies to disrupt Daesh's use of some pretty basic drone technology, but which was causing us a problem.
Is that sort of code for you? You use some kind of cyber element to disrupt the drones?
Yes. You reached a red line there, obviously, and you know, we cyber techniques to affect how a drone operated.
A visible military campaign against Islamic State was mixed with the more covert one, with cyber spies targeting the group's ability to use phones and other devices to communicate.
So we wanted to ensure that when they tried to coordinate attacks on our forces, their devices didn't work, that they couldn't trust the orders that were coming to them from their seniors. They either couldn't trust the messages that were coming to them, or they weren't working.
The UK also hunted Islamic State online, targeting slickly produced videos and other posts.
We prevented their propaganda, you know, both through physical actions on the battlefield, but also remotely getting to their servers, getting to the places that they stored their material.
Much of this was done from GCHQ's headquarters in Cheltenham, locking Islamic State out of their own accounts and deleting or distorting files.
The goal was to stop the terrorist group's media wing from being able to influence people here on the streets of the UK and around the world with news stories and videos glorifying acts of violence and social media posts aimed at enticing them to join the fight. While Islamic State's ideology still remains, much of its extremist material has been taken offline.
The power of cyber to impact people is one reason why the UK has set up a whole new cyber force. Their work is top secret and the threats are vast.
In some respects, the most important, the most relevant use of cyberspace is that the real power is in influence and not in sabotage. And so what you're seeing are our adversaries, our rivals, exploiting the tools that are meant to make for a more utopian society, so things like social media, against us, fueling conspiracy theories and really sowing division and tearing the fabric of society apart. And you know, you could go so far and describe it as almost fueling a civil war inside some of these societies.
Codes and keyboards, the new front line. Deborah Haynes, Sky News.